Dear friends, welcome to another video. This is Nick, and today I am going to show you how to make a phone call with Arduino using the TinySine GSM shield. Let's go! In this video, we build a project where when the button is pressed, Arduino calls a predefined telephone number. Let's try it. I have pressed the button now, and as you can see, the green LED lights up. Now, Arduino is calling my cell phone. Okay, here is the call. If I press the button once more, Arduino hangs up the call. That's it, it works great. Now I am going to press the button again, but this time I have connected a microphone to the pink input so we can hear what Arduino has to say. I will place a small radio close to the microphone and I will move to another room. Let's make a call. As you can see, Arduino is calling. We have connected, we have placed the microphone close to the radio, and let's hear the sound. As you can see, the sound is great. We are using the Arduino cell phone. Now let's see how to connect all the parts together in order to achieve this result. The parts needed in order to build this project are these. We need an Arduino Uno, the TinySine GSM shield, a SIM card in order to use the GSM network, an LED, and a button. Let's connect them together. First, we connect the GSM shield with Arduino Uno. Okay, the SIM card is already placed beneath, and be sure that you have disabled the PIN number from the SIM card. I have prepared many detailed tutorials about the TinySine GSM shield, so watch them first in order to have a better understanding of how this shield works. Now let's connect the button. We connect one leg of the button to breadboard ground and that goes to Arduino ground. We connect the other leg of the button to digital pin 7 of Arduino. Next, we connect the LED. The positive goes to digital pin 13 and the negative to ground. Okay, now we are ready to connect power. Now we have to wait around 30 seconds in order the shield to connect to the GSM network. If we press the button now, the LED will turn on and it will call my cell phone. If I press it again, it will turn off and hang up the call. That's how easy it is to connect all the parts together. Now let's go to the computer to see the software side of the project. The code of the project is very simple. First of all, we need the TinySine GSM library. You can find the library in the description of the video. At first, we connect to the GSM network. If the connection was successful, we read the button state. If the button is pressed and we are not making a call, we make a call. If we are making a call when the button is pressed, we hang up the call. The code can be downloaded from the description of the video. As you can see, making phone calls with Arduino is extremely easy. The projects that we have built today can be quite useful for emergency calls from elderly people or people that can't use phones easily. Now that we know how to make and receive phone calls with Arduino, we can build more advanced projects. How do you plan to use the GSM shield's phone capabilities? Feel free to post your ideas in the comment section below. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post do-it-yourself hardware and software projects every Saturday. I love making things and helping people doing the same. I hope you will join our community. Thank you very much for watching this video. I will see you next Saturday.